The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 15 through 18, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in September of 1966 in New York.
Maya Pritagyana Asuri Bhavamasrita. Last day, we have been discussing four classes of men who come to God and four classes of men who do not come to God. The four classes of men who do not come to God, they are impious, foolish, lowest of the mankind, and their knowledge is taken away by the illusion energy, and they are atheists. Namam duskidanam murha prabaddanti naranhama maya aparhita jnana asuri bhavama sita. We have discussed this point in detail. The next, that four classes of men, Atva Thati Jnani Chavharatamsa. Atva Vijyasu Arthati Jnani Chavharatamsa. Four classes are met who are pious, but at the same time distressed, poverty stricken, and inquirer and inquisitive of transcendental knowledge and Jnani and philosopher. Jigyasu, inquisitive and philosopher. These four classes of men, they come to God. Now, so far, the four classes of men who do not come to God, that means the impious, the foolish, the lowest of the mankind, whose knowledge has been taken away by the illusory energy and atheist. Apart from these classes of men, the four classes of men who come to God, just like artha, distressed, inquisitive, arthati means poverty stricken, and jnani means philosopher. Now, out of these four classes, Lord Krishna says, Tesham jnani nitya jitta eko bhakti visishyate. Out of these four classes, men, one who is philosophically trying to understand the nature of God with devotion, with Krishna consciousness, he is visishyate. Visishyate means he's specially qualified. He's specially qualified. Priyohi jnanina atyartham aham sacha mama priya. For a person who is Krishna conscious at the same time philosophically trying to understand what is the nature of God, so he is very dear to me, Krishna says. He is very dear to me. Because he has no other business than to understand what is God. Others, just like a distressed man, he is in distress, but because he is pious, therefore he believes in God, he goes to the churches, or to the temple, or to the mosque, and prays, my dear Lord, I am very much distressed, kindly help me. But the difficulty of this person is that God does not require to be prayed for asking anything. He is pious, he is distressed, but at the same time he is foolish. Why? He is foolish. because he does not know that God is with me, within my heart. He's sitting along with me, the soul and the super soul. Both of them are sitting together. And God knows everything about me. So I do not require to pray from God to get me out of this distress. He knows everything. Why shall I pray? He leaves everything to God. He does not pray. He prays. He prays to glorify the God, how great you are. Not for his personal interest. Oh God, give me my bread, give me my dress, give me my shelter. That is also good. He's better than the person that murha, the foolish, the atheist, and the lowest of the mankind. He's far better. Even he's going and asking in the church, oh God, give me my daily bread. But at the same time, he's less intelligent. Because he does not know that God is with me. And he knows everything about me. Therefore, one who is pure devotee, he does not pray to God for any personal interest. Even if he is distressed, he says, oh Lord, it is your kindness. You have put me in distress just to rectify me. I would have been put into more and more thousand times in distress, but you are giving me little, that's all. That is your great mercy. That is his vision. He does not. He is not disturbed. Tulla pamana pamana. A person who is in Krishna consciousness, he doesn't care for all this material distress or insult or honor, because he is aloof from this. He knows very well that this designation, this honor, or this insult, they are pertaining to my body, but I am not this body. Just like Socrates was condemned to death because he believed in the an immortality of the soul. So he was condemned to death and he was asked to take hemlock or something like that, poison. And the judge wanted, Socrates, how do you want to be put into the grave? He replied, first of all you catch me, then you put me into the grave. You are dealing with my body, nonsense. I am out of this. You kill me or put me into the grave or whatever you like, I don't mind. First of all you catch me, then you put me into the grave. So this is one who is completely conversant with Krishna science. He knows very well, I am not this body. I am part and parcel of Krishna. My eternal relationship is Krishna, but somewhere or other I have been put into this entanglement of this material body or life. Now I am insane. I get aloof from it. I am not going to be associated with the three qualities of this material nature as we are discussing this morning. I am not concerned with the modes of goodness, and modes of passion, and modes of ignorance. I am concerned with Krishna. Therefore, such a learned and who has understood his real position and his relationship with Krishna, his gaining, he knows. Therefore, he is very much dear to Krishna. And Krishna always guides him. This man who is in distress goes and prays to God. That praying of God is an asset to him. But it may be when he is put into opulence, he forgets God. There is defect in that. But a jnani, one who knows, he never forgets God. His business will go on, continue. Oh. That therefore Krishna says, Tisham jnani nitya yukta. Oh. Jnani is nitya yukta. Jnani is not a, he is not a jnani, or man in knowledge, who is not eternally engaged in the service of Krishna. There is a class of jnani, impersonalist. They say that because to worship impersonal is very difficult for us, so imagine some form of God. They are not jnani, they are fools. Oh, you cannot imagine the form of God. God is so great. That may be your imagination, but that is not the form of God. That is concoction. Oh. They are called iconographer. There are two classes of man, iconoclast and iconographer. Those who imagine the form of God, they are not jnani, they are iconographer. And those who think that I have killed God or I have finished God, they are iconoclasts. Just like in India we have experience. During British days there are Hindu-Muslim riots. So the Hindus would go to the mosque of the Muslim and break it, and the Muslim would go to the temples of the Hindus and break the idol, and they will think that we have finished Hindu's God. Just like Hindus also will think, oh, yet they have broken their mosque, therefore they have broken their God. These are foolishness. In another case I have got experience, when there was non-cooperation movement of Gandhi, the people became riotous and they began to break anything government, especially the post boxes on the street. They thought by breaking the post boxes they are finishing the post office. So these are foolishness. They are not jnani. One who has got real conception of God, they have no quarrel with each other. All the history of religious fight, Hindu, Muslim, or Christian, non-Christian, they are all ignorant. They are all ignorant. One who is in the knowledge, he knows that God is one. God cannot be Hindu, God cannot be Muslim, God cannot be Christian. God is God. He has no material qualification. It is our conception that God is certain self, God is certain self. That is imagination. That is called iconographer. So they are not dead. They are not man in knowledge. Man in knowledge is different. He knows that God is transcendental. Just like even Shankaracharya, the impersonalist, he says, Narayana para abhatyat. And in the morning also, we have discussed this one, that one who knows God transcendental, above this material quality, he knows. So therefore, Krishna says here, Priyohi Jnanina Atyartham. The man who is actually in knowledge of the science of God is very dear to God. Priyohi Jnanina Atyartham Aham Satya Mamapriya. That is a personal relationship with the devotee of God. The devotee, he does not know anything beyond God, and God also does not know anything beyond his devotee. So sweet relation. God is always after me, as we have discussed many times, that he is sitting in the same tree, in this heart I am sitting, and my friend God is also sitting, super soul, eternal, wherever I am taking my transmigration. When I leave this body and enter into another body, God also goes there just to see what I am doing. When I shall turn my face towards him, he is simply waiting. And as soon as I turn my face towards God, he says, my dear son, come on. Satama mapriya. God says, you are eternally dear to me. Now you are turning your face to me. So I am very glad. Therefore, Gyani, one who understands the science of God, simply God is good. That is also very good. But one should understand what is it. That science of God is Srimad Bhagavata and Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavata. Bhagavad Gita is the preliminary study of the science of God. So, anyone who is actually interested in God, they should study the science of God, Bhagavad Gita. Vijnanam is science. Jnanam me paramam guhyam jad vijnanam samannitam. In the Bhagavad there is a statement like this. The jnanam means knowledge. Paramam guhyam, very confidential. Very subtle and confidential. Paramam guhyam jad vijnanam samannitam, which is full of scientific knowledge. Sarhasam, it is full of mystery also. Jnanam me paramam guhyam jad vijnanam samannitam sarhasam tad angancha. And how to understand the different departmental knowledge of God. Grihita gadidarmaya. That knowledge can be imparted by God Himself. You cannot manufacture the knowledge of God. Just as you discover some scientific knowledge of this material world, similarly, you cannot discover God by such knowledge. That is not possible. The knowledge of God can be had when it is explained by God Himself or a bona fide representative of God. That is the process. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita you find yada yada hi dhanma stagnani bhavati bharata abhutthanam adhanmasya tadatmanam sujamaham. Whenever there is discrepancy in the matter of understanding the science of God, at that time I incarnate myself. Because this whole system is like that it is an opportunity to the conditioned soul to recoup themselves, to come back to God. This whole material creation is there, manifestation is there, to give the conditioned soul an opportunity to recoup himself and to understand what is his relationship with God and come back to God. So anyone who is very much inquisitive and at the same time eager to understand his relationship with God, he is called a jnani, a man in knowledge. And he is very dear to Krishna. It is not a sentiment. By sentiment you talk some nonsense. That is not bhakti. That is not their devotion. Devotion is not sentiment. It is a science. Rupa Goswami says, Suti Siti Puranadi Pancharatriki Vidhir Vina Poikantiki Hare Bhakti Utpata Eva Kalpate. He says that a show of devotion, a show of spirituality, a show of devotion, a show of spirituality without reference to the Vedic knowledge, Suti Sriti, and corollary to the Veda, Pancharatriki Vidhin, and the definition of Bhakti Sutra, like Narada Bhakti Sutra, and such authoritative books. We come to the Hare Bhakti. If a man is showing himself that he is very great devotee and a man in knowledge, without any reference of the authoritative shastra books, that is simply disturbance. Utpat means disturbance. A man showing that he is a great devotee, a great man of knowledge, but he has no reference to the books of knowledge, or the authoritative books, that is simply creating disturbance. That is not religious, it is neither devotion, nothing else. So, this Krishna consciousness is a science. We have to take it scientifically, as they are described in the authoritative books, and test it by your reason and arguments and knowledge, and follow it. It is science. It is not sentiment. Whatever you are doing here, the dancing, singing, and everything, that is all scientific. Simply you have to understand it. Therefore, jnani, only a person who is in knowledge, who is in knowledge of the science of Krishna, he can make an rapid advancement, and he is very dear to Krishna. Because it's slow but sure, he is making sure progress. It is no sentiment. So jnani, priyahi jnanina atyartham, atyartham means very aham. Krishna is very dear to the person in knowledge, and that man is also very dear to Krishna. Reciprocal. If you love Krishna, then Krishna will love more than you. You can what capacity has got to love Krishna? But Krishna in love, he has got immense capacity. So that is fact. And what is next? Now, Krishna says, Udara sarva evaite jnani tatmaiva mehmatam asita sahi yuktatma mameva anuttamam gati. Now those persons, those who are distressed and those who are poverty stricken, they go to God, they pray to God. Now Krishna is accepting their endeavor. Udara sarveti. They are all of them, these four classes of men, either he's coming to me in distress, or being poverty-stricken, or as inquisitive, or as real a man of knowledge, they are welcome. They are welcome. Udara. They are very good. Survey with it. But out of them, jnani to atmaiva me matam is still that person who is in knowledge is very gentle. He still is confined. So one should be in knowledge. Devotional service, it is sad. And why others are welcome? Those who are distressed has come to God, and those who are in poverty situation has come to God. Why they are also welcome? They are welcome in the sense that because you have come to God in course of time, they will also become as good as a man in knowledge, in the country. But generally, it happens, one goes to the church for some profit. If the profit is not there, he says it is lost. He gives up all connection with church. I got information from one of my god brothers. He's German. He told me that during war time, many Germans they went to war, and their wives, sisters, all women class, they went to church and prayed for the return of their husband, brother, or son, but they did not return, and all of them became atheists. Oh, there is no war. There is no war. Sometimes it happens like that, that we want God as my order supplier. If he does not supply the order, then he becomes no God. There is no God. That is the defect of this kind of prayer. But if they continue, now I'll give you one example. There is a little boy, 5 years old, a royal family, Maharaj Dhruva. He was insulted by his stepmother. The little boy was sitting on the lap of his father, and his stepmother dragged the boy. Oh, you cannot sit on the father, on the lap of your father, because you are not born of me. Oh, the boy became very much angry, because he was the son of a Kshatriya. They are in most of passion. So he took it a great insult, and he went to his own mother. The king had 2 queens. Senior queen had this boy, and the junior queen had no son. So junior queen was very much envious of this boy. So she dragged the boy from the lap of his father. But the boy felt insulted. He went to his mother and cried, "My mother, junior mother has insulted me in this way. I was sitting. Oh, yes, my boy, what can I do? I am helpless. Your father does not like me. Then, how can I take revenge? Oh, my dear boy, you are helpless. If God helps you, then he can take revenge. Because womanly character. Oh, where is God? She said, "Oh, I understand. So many great sages and saints go to the jungle and forest. They see God there. They undergo penances and austerities and then find God there." Oh, he at once went to the forest. Then he was asking the tiger, "Oh, you are God. The elephant, you are God." In this way, when Narayan saw, oh, this boy is very much inquisitive. So he sent Narad that go and see what is the condition of this boy. So Narad came. Narad is the agent of God. "My dear boy, you are royal, you belong to the royal family. You cannot suffer all this penance and austerity. Please go back to your home. Your father is very much anxious for you. Your mother is very much anxious for you." The boy said, "My dear sir, you don't try to deceive me in that way. If you know something about God, how can I see God? Then tell me. Otherwise, go out. Don't disturb." So, here you are far with them. Now, this boy was initiated by Narada. When he saw that this boy is determined, then he initiated him and gave him mantra, yes. Namo Bhagavati Vasudevaya. He chanted that mantra and became perfect, and God came before him. Now when God came before him, God offered him, "My dear Dhruva, what do you want? Check whatever you like. Then Dhruva say, my dear sir, sana vilasis tapasi situham. Oh, I was situated in this severe type of penance simply for the matter of my father's kingdom, a land. Sana vilasis tapasi situham. Swam Satman Devamuninda Vyam. But I have now seen you, and you who is impossible to be seen even by the great sages and great friends, so I have seen you. So what is my prophet? Nakasam Vichinam Apidibharatnam. As if I came out of my home to find out some particles of glass, but I have found out a very valuable diamond. Samin Kitathosmi Baranga Jate. Oh, I am satisfied. I have no necessity of asking so. So, if anyone, either in distressed condition or in poverty stricken, if he goes to God and just like the same determination like Dhruva, that I must see God and take this benediction from God, and if he happens to God, see God, if he understands God, then he no more wants to have anything material. He understands that all this material nonsense is foolish. Have God the real thing. Jangalabdha chaparangalabhanga mannate nabhitam tatha. Who is gaining, he'll find in the Bhagavad Gita. When one actually in Krishna consciousness, he does not want anything. Just like Dhruva Maharaj. Samin kitathosmi barangna jati. My dear Lord, I am fully satisfied. I don't want it. I am not distressed. I am not poverty stricken. I am the wealthiest. Oh. There is no comparison of my assets. That position becomes true. Therefore, Krishna says that Udara, they are also good, because gradually they will come to this understanding. Because Jnani knows that what are these material things? They are only flickering. Suppose I get too much wealth and too much everything, what is this material? La puja pratistha. This material assets are three. Something I want some gain out of my work, profit. And puja. Puja means people will adore me. Oh, you are such a rich man. You are so great man. La puja and pratistha and fame. People may know me that I am Carnegie, I am Rockefeller, I am Birla. But he does not know that Birla and Rockefeller is this body. As soon as this body is finished, all Birla, Rockefeller is finished, then I do not know whether I am entering to cat or dog. Because after finishing this body, you are neither Birla, neither Rockefeller. You are a spirit soul, and according to your own karma, according to your own work, you have to enter another body, which is different from Birla and Carnegie. Again, he knows. So why shall I bother myself for this temporary designation? That is Jnani. He's Jnani. He's man in knowledge. I am pure soul. My eternal connection is Krishna, the Supreme Lord. Let me establish that connection very firmly, so that Krishna may take me back into his kingdom. That is my duty. So, this is the preference to the Jnani, that's all. Although, these persons who come to the shelter of God, being distressed or being poverty-stricken, they are also welcome, because there may be chance that one day he may be fully in knowledge. So, I don't want all these material things. I want simply you. That is my mission. That is my life mission. One should take it like that. Then that is perfect life. The whole, my cosmic situation is giving us all facilities that you should enjoy. So far body is concerned, you get all things supplied by you. I supply by God. You have got enough grains, you have got enough fruits, you have got enough meat, you have got everything enough. You eat it, live peacefully, because what is my want of this body? Ahara nidra bhayamai dhunancha. You can eat. Ahara means eating. So you can eat, sufficiently. Nidra, you can make shelter. God has given you so many woods, so many, plants you can get, make your home. That's all right, sleep there peacefully. And ahara nidra bhaya, and you can defend as far as possible. Then, you want sex life, all right. There are so many women, get them married. Live peacefully. And culture, God consciousness, Krishna consciousness. That arrangement is there. Why don't you do it? Why do you want more and more, more and more, more and more? This is foolishness. So far your material necessities are concerned, there is enough. All right, you are eating, can your manufacturing process can supply eating from the factories? No. Then why do you bother about this factory? Why you spoil your energy? Just eat, be satisfied, whatever God has given you. And culture, devote your time for reviving your eternal relationship with God. Plain living and high thinking. That is the best type of civilization. You want sex? Can you manufacture sex in the factory? No. Then it is supplied by God. So everything, whatever you require, that is supplied by God. You take advantage of it. And be God conscious or Krishna conscious. That is your business. So, God has given us all facilities to come to Him. But we are unfortunate. And He has given us still more facilities in this age. Because in this age, we are all unfortunate, short living. So, even we have no facilities for the primary necessities of life. Ahara nidra bhayamaitama. Eating, sleeping, and defending and mating. These things are absolutely necessary for keeping the body fit. But we have no such arrangement even that. In this age. There are so many people who have no shelter, so many people who have no food, so many people who have no marriage life, no sex life. And there are so many people not dependent from the onslaught of nature. This age is like that. Therefore, in this age, Lord Chaitanya recommended, but because I have no facility even for my material body, still I have to make progress in the spiritual life. How to do it? Harinama, 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 Yokivalam, Kaluna, Sivana, 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 Sivana. It just all is chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Never mind you are in factory, never mind you are in hell, never mind you are in, the skyscraper houses. Go on chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Ram. There is no expense, there is no bar, there is no caste, there is no creed, there is no color, anyone. Chant and hear, chant and hear. Nidhara sarvita jnanitātma ishamimatam āsitam sahi juttātma māmeva anuttamām gati. So, somewhere or other, if anyone comes in contact with God, God consciousness, a Krishna consciousness, and he prosecutes the energy rightly under the direction of a bona fide guide, then he is sure to go back to God. All right. Any questions?